This afternoon, we wish to engage in an open dialogue between the representatives of three Latin American countries and the general public.
For these 3 hours, we can be influenced in a constructive manner our way of thinking and the set of beliefs we have about Latin America, and in particular, the guest countries here today, Bolivia, Cuba, and Venezuela.
The balance of power in the Americas is on the verge of radical change.
I'm Andrea Pungak, student of international relations.
My name is Rodrigo Fernandez. I'm a PhD candidate from the geography department.
Why did Mr. Chavez go to Iran at that moment?
How can you say what are their achievements of 10 years of revolution?
At the cornerstone of what we see as a change, a profound change, in the balance of power in our region, in Latin America, there is no escaping making the reference to Cuba 1959. How do you explain, thinking outside the box, the permanence of the Cuban revolutionary process?
The participative and social democracy has allowed us to keep on going with the redistribution of power in the Venezuelan society, based on work and solidarity, which in response to neoliberalism gave birth to 21st century socialism.
We have witnessed a new type of left politics sweeping the entire region. In Spanish, we might say un giro hacia la izquierda, a socialism of the 21st century.
Cuando el presidente Chávez llegó al gobierno, en 1998, había 80% de población en condición de pobreza, de manera que la única respuesta era un conflicto social abierto. Hoy por hoy, esa situación se ha resuelto a través de un conjunto de reformas y de cambios estructurales profundos cuya principal señal es la inclusión social.
What does President Chávez mean when he talks about 21st century socialism?
Socialismo del siglo XXI es una oportunidad de los pueblos para construir una nueva realidad frente al pensamiento y a la propuesta neoliberal, reconociendo las corrientes de pensamiento tradicional y los aportes propios de América Latina y de nuestros pensadores en particular.
As you know, we have a new constitution, and we are now not anymore a republic, but we are a plurinational state. How this indigenous movement became a social movement? Because nowadays, the actual government of Evo Morales is a government of the social movements and of the indigenous movements. Indigenous people were condemned into the main square. They had to wear out. It was a violation to the basic human rights. Bolivian state, all companies were privatized. The exportation of gas and telecommunication, electricity company, and all the main strategic. We became very fundamentalist in the neoliberal policies. That's what happened in Cochabamba in 2002. People were more aware about our natural resources. We had the nationalization in 2006. The new role of the state came very strong. Again, control over our resources. It has been turned around because we are obtaining about 80% of the resources. This allows Evo Morales to make a very strong social policy. The people could see, okay, my child is receiving $20 of these resources based on other principles of solidarity, of reciprocity. 36 different nations in Bolivia, indigenous nations. In the indigenous vision, we are very strong about the environment. The vision of our strategic development plan in Bolivia is based on an indigenous philosophy, which is called to live well. Not to live better, just to live well. Contribute to the creation of a fair, diverse, inclusive, balanced world in a harmony with nature. This harmony with nature and between human beings is opposed of this individualistic and accumulation vision of the capitalist model. South America, there is a very big integration process going on.
Most extraordinarily, a solid movement against the established order. There is no possibility of explaining the continuity, of explaining that capacity for reinvention, that determination and willpower, except for the fact that its roots are still deep down in the people of Cuba.
Revenue that oil has generated. Okay, my name is Oscar. Where is the $250 billion in profits that is estimated by economists in Venezuela? Where has that money gone?
Lo más importante es señalar aquí que anterior al proceso de renacionalización que emprendió el presidente Chávez, solamente 500 empresas manejaban todo el negocio petrolero en Venezuela. Y estamos hablando de la industria que genera más de 20 mil millones de dólares al año. Esa estructura se rompió por completo. Y se han formado cantidad de cooperativas que viven dignamente a partir de la actividad económica que generan en las industrias petroleras. Acerca del cierre de Radio Caracas Televisión.
Excuse me, please.
Obviamente usted fija una posición y es respetable.
Simplemente se venció la concesión y el gobierno tomó la decisión que le corresponde como gobierno.
The relationship between the EU and Latin America.
Our purpose is to find perfectly working, rational and mutually beneficial relations with all European nations with which we have full diplomatic relations.
But Europe now wants to go individually, which each country have to have another trade agreement. And this is one of the main factors also why we are not developing further the dialogue between the trade agreement which is looking the European Union with the Andean region.
We are traditionally misbehaviors. We have not bowed down to impositions coming from outside, if we haven't taken them from the Americans, much less are we going to take them from Europe.
Definitivamente necesitamos un nuevo orden internacional y en eso luchamos.
And bring us back to the discussion of what is isolation. The policy that was initiated back in 1962.
We are against the seven bases. We think bases don't promote peace, and we have to respect each other. Bases don't promote democracy. The Americans had a long history dealing with dictatorships, but not with democracy.
Me gusta estar al lado del camino, fumando el humo mientras todo pasa. Cuando se hallan dos balas sobre un campo de guerra, algo debe ocurrir.